Happy Valentine's Day. So, this is Lovers in a Dangerous Spacetime. As you may or may not know, this game has only one game mode, local co-op. That means no single player and no online. And, of course, this means you can only play with two controllers at least. Unless, of course, you don't. For instance, right now, I can do this, and then I can this, and I can do this, and this. There we go. Not like this. See what I have again. Hopper. Sure. Let's go with Hopper. Button. And X. Two, and that one's a bunny. So, let's go see. I've been playing this one already, but let's go for the tutorial. Just to get into the swing of it. It's not Hopsy Flopsy, HQ, blah, blah, blah. Oh no, the ship's about to be destroyed. Well, no, it's not. Here they come, shield and engine pods. Okay, so you have to actually shoot these things at roughly the same time, which means you probably can't do this. So we need someone else. Let's go with this guy. This right there. Works just fine. I'm gonna put someone on there, which is gonna be this guy. It works. Hey, it's this one again. This time it's the flight controls. Or steering. Whatever. Oh, that one. Just fine. So now this guy can probably just steer it. Go. Off. And say I'm off. All four of me. It's going smoothly. Yeah, okay. So how is this done? Well, here is how. This is my thing. Here's my configuration. So, this is player one who's using the controller. It's like a normal player would. It's like, my actions are all these things. You have to set the bindings yourself. And this is where the magic happens. This one, I can choose which player I'm going to be. If I press the white button, I change to player 2. The reason for that is because player 2 is the yellow character. Yellow button, yellow character. Makes sense. And that is also the case for X, being blue. And B being, well, orange. Isn't really red, but orange is good enough. And of course, green is player 1. And so he gets relegated to player 1. And then every one of these has exactly the same controls, for the most part. Yeah, and thus every character can do everything the other character can do just fine. And that's how this guy is put him here. And I prefer to keep my characters in specific position. This actually makes the game maybe a little bit easier, maybe not. The benefit of this is that you can actually put persons in the relegated position. If you have two people and you're doing the whole ship with just two people, you're going to have to move around the whole lot, of course, because, you know, you can't really do the shields and the guns and propulsion at the same time. But I can just do, like, press a button, and there it goes. That's the shield. Press another button, and off I go. And some enemies, and I'm going to shoot them. And there it is, and I win. Yay. Okay. Now, there is one particular advantage to having... Oh no, it's the American prototype. So, the way the cannons are laid out is I have one to the left and one to the right. I could cover pretty much everything with that. Almost everything. Some things I cannot. There's this huge blind spot right there on the top. It's not fun. And of course I can... There it is! Hey! So I also don't have to really move my characters around. That's basically the advantage. I don't have to move my characters around to different cans, even though I have four. I can just keep two of them occupying pretty much everything. The Yamato cannon, it's super useless. Don't use it. Not until you get like an upgrade for it. Preferably metal one. It turns into a saw blade that goes like a little extra fast. Oh, that's good. Die! I need five more. Well, four more. We have one. Well, let's go get them. There's one. Let's just move up a bit and. There it is. See, you don't have to move your characters around to shoot whatever you want to shoot. You can just move the ship around and get a advantage point in that. So now I'm just cruising around and hey, it's my ship's module for maps. And this is one of those stations that you don't really need to keep occupied at all times, so that's also one thing you don't really have to relegate much power to. For instance, I'm not usually flying around and looking at the map at the same time, so I just put this one over here and there's the map. Of course, you can probably do something that's this one here. That's cool. Map. Okay. But that's really only if I'm really lost. And since I'm a man, I'm pretty good with maps. I can store it in my brain's RAM. And can plot out a course just fine. Okay, well, I'm pretty much backed into a corner, which is good. You can't hurt me. Well, you can, but, you know, that's the thought that counts. See, if I back up a bit, it's probably better. Yay, more friends. Anti-love crew. Why is it not working? Come on. There we go. And that's three of them. There's one, two, four. Yay. Now I know where they are. Let's go find out where they are. There they are. Well, one of them, at least. There could be more. Could be less than two. Gonna be at least one anyway. So let's go rescue that and then get the hell out of here. Get the tutorial and such. So if you're interested, this is controls. This is important. The player one keyboard has to be empty. Player two has to be all that. It doesn't really matter what you're putting on the gamepad, because the Steam controller can only emulate one controller, but can do the whole keyboard as well, and so the whole keyboard is Mac. That's nice. The actual keys you put on the keyboard don't matter. They just have to match up with this. So player 4 is using the keypad, why not? And as such, the whole keypad has to be bound, according. Since. Oh no, it's a thing. That's okay. I got a shield. I am not planning on getting damaged. Did anyway. Yeah, you can't hurt me. Well, I can. Only if I wanted to. And there are the last two. We were bunched up together all along. That saves so much time. Oh, it's so happy and friendly and happy Valentine's Day. Let's get down out of here. Eat shit. Yeah, I don't need to move him around. He's just fine right there. There's another radar, which I don't need because I already have everything. Pretty sure of it. Oh no, there's things coming up from above. What do I do? Well, I could take it like a bitch, or move around a bit. Shoot. Now, of course, this whole setup has issues. It's got problems. It's not always going to be flawless, and it can and will get extremely overrun. There it is. It's the ending. Yay. Crap. Right. And that's basically how you play this game on your own. So don't let the man tell you what you can or cannot play. You are your own boss, or your own companion, or your own lover, whatever. Peace.